Good morning, students.
Good morning.
So, how are you feeling today? First class, first day, right in the morning. Tired, boring, active?
Active.
Pakka? Okay. Let me ask you some very basic questions, right? What's your name?
Roshni.
Can you just describe what you did from morning till now?
So, I had my breakfast.
You woke up, perhaps you had a brush. You used a toothpaste and a brush. Which brand do you use?
Colgate.
Okay. And then? You cooked your food for yourself. Your mother did it for you?
Mother cooked.
Your mother cooked. Very nice. Okay. And then what did you have in breakfast?
Omelette and bread.
Tab to energy hona chahiye yaar. Why are you looking so tired? Okay. What did you do next?
Got ready.
Okay. What transportation did you take to come here?
By auto.
Auto. Fine. So, you know, why I'm asking this to Roshni is very relevant for maybe Nitai also. Nitai, what did you do? Did you do anything different from what Roshni did?
Actually, by bus. I came here.
You came by bus. But again, you got up, you had brush, your mother perhaps cooked food for you or your wife did, and you came here by bus and you are attending here a session on service tax, right? Why I'm asking you all this is very relevant for us. If we just, you know, categorize into what happened to us today, we took a brush and a Colgate or something, Pepsodent or something like that. We could feel the brush, we could feel the Colgate, right? We had food in the morning. Perhaps somebody had an omelette, somebody had a bread. Again, we could feel that egg and omelette going inside our stomach, isn't it? Then you had an auto, you had a bus, somebody else might have a taxi, a metro. Again, you can feel. So all these are tangible things. You know, you're sitting in a chair, you're using a book, somebody's using a pencil, rubber, all these are tangible things which we are known as goods. We touch and we are conscious about that, right? But we somehow subconsciously miss certain intangible things. You got up, your mother cooked for you. That is not tangible. The auto wala or the bus driver drove you to here. That's not tangible. I'm standing here and teaching you. The book is tangible, but this teaching is not tangible. So the point that I'm about to bring home is, there are two things that we experience every day. One is tangible, the other is intangible. The tangible things, brush, Pepsodent, Colgate, auto, food, books. And the intangible part, perhaps which subconsciously we do not notice, is your mother cooking for you. The auto wala driving for you, the bus wala driving for you, the teacher teaching to you, right? So we can categorize everything perhaps in two broad terms. One is goods and the other one is a service. The mother is offering a cooking service to you. The auto wala, bus wala is offering a driving service to you. The teacher is offering a coaching service to you. We all understood that, you know, goods, when we sell or we buy, there is a taxation. But there is also a service element involved. Sometimes there are transactions whereas there is no goods involved. For example, me teaching you today, there is no goods involved. What I am giving you is only a service for which I will earn some revenue. If there is a tax on sale of goods, why should not there be a tax on sale of services? So, if there is to be a tax on services, it also becomes very important that what is service? For example, we all know what is a goods. This is a good. We can touch, we can feel, we can go to the market, we can buy it. And there is a sale tax or a VAT on the sale of goods. But there is a sale of service. A teacher teaching to you. There is a sale of service. A bus driver driving a bus for you to transport you from your home to this place. So there is a sale of service for which you pay. Hence, the government thought that if there is a tax on sale of goods, why should not there be a tax on sale of services? Now, the most important thing here is, if you see the examples that I took, mother cooking food for you, there is no monetary consideration. She is cooking food for you out of your love, affection. But an auto wala bringing here is a service which is chargeable. He might have taken 8 rupees or 10 rupees, or a bus wala bringing here might have taken 5 rupees, or a taxi wala 100 rupees. So there is a consideration. So the government imposed tax on sale of services as well. Now, the next that I'm going to write on board is very, very important for us. The entire fundamental of service tax depends on this, what I'm going to write. If you can really understand what this is all about, service tax will be very, very easy for you. To understand, it will be very, very easy for you. Even if somebody has no idea on taxation, if you can follow this, service tax will become very, very easy for you, right? The most important thing is the definition of service as provided in the law, okay? So please have a look at this. Any activity carried out by one person for another for a consideration. Now, let us understand in terms of the examples we discussed, right? Rajshri, your mother cooks for you. That is an activity. Cooking is an activity carried out by one person, which is your mother, for Rajshri, for a consideration. This is missing. So perhaps that is not service as per the definition of the law, right? So any activity which is carried out by one person for another for a consideration is service. So it has to be an activity by one person for another, which means there has to be two people involved and for a consideration. For example, if I brush my own teeth, I'm carrying out an activity is brushing, but I'm doing it for myself. There are no two people involved. So that is not service. So important thing is that the activity must be carried out by one person for another and for a consideration, right?